Hey guys, Kevin here. Today we're going to talk about how to take the this kind of printer apart. Then I'm going to walk you through the different parts inside the printer.
If you want to remove this part, it is secured by the tab on both sides. Just lift it up and use your finger to pull the part, and it can be removed easily. To put it back, just line it up and push vertically, push it down. And for the front unit, you have to sort of like bend in the middle, and then it will come off. To put it back in, insert one of the tab, then you can sort of like slide another tab, and it will be lined up, and you can close it. Okay, let's take the printer apart. You will need a number 2 Phillips screwdriver, and try to get a really long one. In the back of the printer, remove this screw, and then remove the cover for the fax unit. Then remove this screw on the top of the scanner. I'll take out the duplex roller and the waste tanks, and remove the paper trays. There's a tab on the right side of the scanner, so push your thumb there and pull it towards your right. And close the cover, and then you can lift the whole thing up. I have a whole video about how to remove and install the scanner, so I'll put a link above. Now we're gonna take the cover off. First, we remove the hinge. And remove the screw underneath the hinge. That's why you need the long screwdriver. The second screw is in this hole. The fourth one is here. The fifth one is on the top. The sixth one is the one that below it. Finally, the seventh one is in that hole.
So how many we remove so far? We call 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7.
Now we can get the whole cover removed. Okay, let's work through some major things. You got the power supply, fax module, and the main board or motherboard, a printhead carriage, and a front panel. So if we think of the printer as a two-dimensional machine, so we get the printhead move in the X-axis. Call this a carriage assembly or CR assembly. Then we have a paper moving in the Y direction, and we call it a PF assembly or paper feed assembly. Let's cover the CR carriage assembly first. If your printhead is locked, you can pull the carriage to your right a little bit. Then rotate this rod counterclockwise. You'll see the lock is released on the right side.
The movement is controlled by this belt. So this belt, then there's a pulley, and the motor is here. So the motor drives this pulley to move the printhead back and forth. This is an encoder belt that tell the printer how far it moved. Let me take it off, just show you. If you see here, it has a really fine mesh.
The encoder scale is read by this CR sensor. Basically, it tells the printer where the printhead is at. So what about those cables? This printhead has two columns. Normally, Epson use one cable to control each column. So you get two white cables. By the way, all those parts, you can go to bchtechnologies.com and then go to printer parts and Epson, and there are categories, like, for example, printhead carriage and cables, flex cables. Those 9x2 cables, if you count the pins, there are 9 pins, then there's a gap, then there's another set of 9 pins. Then there's 8x2 cables. So this cable has 8 pins, a gap, then 8 pins. At the end, it's split into 2 8x1 cables. One of the 8x1 goes to the CR encoder reader, the sensor. Another set of 8 pins go to this CR contact module. And another set of contact module is contact with this CSIC terminal. And the CSIC terminal, which we call it a 9-pin chipboard pin, that's going to contact with the cartridge. And that's that one reads the cartridge ink level. On the bottom of the carriage, if you pay attention to that little green thing, that's the paper width sensor. Paper width sensor is pretty small. It's also a photo sensor, like a PIS. It detects how wide the paper is. Okay, that concludes the CR side. Take a snapshot and so you can know which part is which. Okay, paper feed or PF. And here's the rear end paper guide. Those white things are called a stopper. So the paper come up, get the stopper, then they come with a roller and and get fit in here. Back of this is the stopper, and this is the paper pickup arm. So I lower it down, and then touch the paper, and I feed the paper upwards. So when the paper get fed to the upper level, This is a paper eject sensor, the lever. Underneath, there's a sensor. Here's how PE sensor works. The PE sensor is on the bottom, and the lever is on the top. So if I have a piece of paper, that will push the lever away from the sensor. The PE sensor's lever is installed on this white part. It is called paper guide upper assembly. In the back is suspended by those by 5 springs. In the front, those rollers going to push the paper down, so make sure the paper is flat. On the left side, we have a PF motor that drives this timing belt. Here's another pulley and that spring. In the front, there's another roller. This is a PE roller, paper eject roller. And this roller is called a PF roller, paper feed roller. The PF roller is connected to another encoder, but this time is a disk. You can see the vertical lines, and which is read by the PF encoder sensor. Here's the star wheel assembly. Some people call it a pizza wheel assembly. And inside the assembly, here's the photo ink sensor or PIS sensor. Okay, still here? Why not just subscribe to my channel and come back and watch the rest? Anyway, if you have a double decker, let me show you how to take the top off. So first screw is right here. And the second screw is here. And third one is down there. The fourth one, you have look down the PF motor. And the fifth one is underneath. So you have to take this apart. You take this board off first. And disconnect the tube. There's one screw here, you have to pull it, and you will be able to see it. And then there's another screw around this corner. Now this unit can be removed. We'll remove the unit. Remember, take this lever off, and I'm going to post another video show you how to put it on. This is very easy to get lost. I'm going to have magnet nearby to catch that spring if I ever get lost. All those trouble is for that screw right here. That's the fifth. The seventh screw is in that hole. So underneath you have another motor, that's the pickup motor that drives this pickup arm. And also, this pickup motor also has a pickup encoder. And just like the PF encoder, this pickup encoder is in a disk. And also on the bottom, there's a tree sensor that if you push the paper tray in, that's going to push this lever so the printer will know you inserted a paper tray. Okay, that concludes the paper feed, PF. Okay, let's go over the sensors. So for the photo type of sensor, we have a paper width sensor. And then we have a PIS sensor on the star wheel. And then we have a PE sensor, a paper eject sensor. So for the encoder type of sensors, we have a CR sensor that's in a belt or strip, whatever you call it. And then we have two encoder disks. One is the PF, paper feed, and that's on the left side. Then underneath, we have a paper pickup disk. For the lever type sensors, one is on the top of the printer, and you push it down, and the printer knows you close the printer lid. And then there's a tray sensor on the bottom, which detects if you insert a paper tray or not. Two photo sensors, one PE sensor, three encoders, and two lever type sensor. Motors, there are three motors. Carriage motor, CR motor, the PF motor, paper feed motor, and the pickup motor underneath. If you need those drawings, so you can go to bchtechnologies.com, go to printer parts, and just click any category, for example, PF. That should have this nice picture about all the PF parts. I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at www.bchtechnologies.com or locally, Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers!
There was a time not long ago when printer cartridges were so expensive.
So expensive.
Then BCH came out to play. The quality cartridges saved the day. Oh, oh, oh.